Kris, you've rejoined your club mates on tour in Austria. Is it good to be back?
Yeah, nice to be back. Meet all the boys again, the new staff, everyone around the club.
It's exciting times, isn't it, for the club? A lot of change. Obviously a disappointing season last year, but everybody looking forward now and hoping for some better times ahead.
Yeah, for sure. Especially like you said, like it was really disappointing end of last year with the relegation and everything. And it's difficult, but in the end, I think everyone around the club sees as well it's going to be all changes, and hopefully it's going to mean a brighter future for the club.
Lots of the lads have been on long holidays. You've had quite a busy summer.
It's been right, to be fair. Not that many free days, but a nice World Cup in between. So
tell us about the World Cup experience.
No, it's I think once in a lifetime for, especially if you come from a country like Sweden. It's not that often we qualify for the big tournaments, and getting there and doing so well, and yeah, amazing.
You had some good results in the group. You beat Ki Sung Young's Korea and Mexico, a really good win.
Yeah, obviously. Seeing the drawing and everything, we knew we had a handful in the group with them teams. So, yeah, first of all, qualifying and then winning the group as well. So I think we did a lot more than what anyone expected. After winning the group, we had a kind of feeling that it didn't really matter who we played. We got a good chance against anyone. So massive team spirit, and just we kept bulldozing on.
What was the England game like?
Disappointing. I think we didn't really perform at the level we did in the other games, and but obviously a big disappointment, especially after the game and maybe one or two days after. And after that, I think when you look back at it, it's been an amazing summer for the whole country.
Is Sweden's number one? Is that a target for you?
Yeah, obviously, like I haven't played that much here the last couple of years, and still being selected and getting that confidence from the manager of Sweden is obviously massive, and hopefully I can play some more games now here and keep pushing for the first spot for Sweden.
The goalkeeper's jersey is there to be taken. It's a big moment for you, isn't it, in your Swans career?
Yeah, for sure. In the last couple of years, I've been trying to take it as well, but fair play to him. He's done amazing work here during his spell at the club, and hopefully I can take the jersey now and keep the same path.
Yeah, what was it like for you? Because as you say, Lukasz, to his credit, was very consistent, wasn't he? Do you, as a fellow goalkeeper, do you applaud that and accept that you have to sit on the bench and wait for your turn?
Obviously not. Like, I think every professional athlete is not happy if they're not playing, but like I said, it was fair play to him. He performed really well during some of the seasons. It's not that often you get a substitute or something like that. It's more like an injury or a send-off or something like that. The second choice is going to get the nod, but yeah, it's all about staying focused and being ready when you get the chance. I think I know my abilities, and I hope I can show them now in the pre-season for the new staff.
Tell us, because you know better than all of us, how was Graham Potter and the work he did at Östersund, how was that regarded in Sweden?
No, highly, for sure. Being such a small club, really up north, not really like a football city or anything, but making in like short period of time a big impression in Swedish football, make it to the Europa League, beating Arsenal at the Emirates, nah, massive.
The hope is now, obviously, that he can have a similar impact at Swansea.
Yeah, for sure. I think it's a bit different. This is a lot bigger club, and with everything around the club as well, it's going to be a big test for him and for the squad as well.
And the Championship, Kris, this season, lots of games. It's known as a very competitive league. How do you think you guys can go this season?
No, I think we'll do well, for sure. I think all of us has the ambition to promote. Everybody knows it's a really tough league, and like you say, it's 46 games. It's not a short season. So it's going to be ups and it's going to be downs, but just make sure the downs are really, really quick and not that many.